And it all begins when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam receives the news that Abu Sufyan is leading a great caravan of hundreds of camels being carried with many stocks. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marches out of Medina with a small number of companions, 313. They are going to attack the caravan of Abu Sufyan. And who they're going to fight? 40, 50, 60 men? There's 313 of us. But Abu Sufyan was smart. So Abu Sufyan managed to escape. And at the same time, Abu Sufyan, and that's before Abu Sufyan was a Muslim, sent one of his men to the people of Quraysh, calling upon the people of Quraysh, saying to them that Muhammad had came out with 313 soldiers to attack your wolf and your caravan. So prepare an army and come out to attack Muhammad. So Abu Jahl, la'anahullah, with all this hostility and enmity towards Islam and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he prepared an army of 1,300 soldiers. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam is not prepared. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was sharing one camel with two other companions until the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam arrives to Badr, until that moment came where the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is addressing his companion, is reminding the believers what Allah Azza wa Jal had promised them, either victory in the battle of Badr or paradise to those who die in this battlefield. How could an army lose when it's assisted by Allah? How could an army lose when it's supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And there the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that night, while all the companions are sleeping, my Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was awake. Awake with who? Awake with his Lord, Allah Almighty, asking Allah Azza wa Jal to give this minority soldiers victory over their enemies. Until that moment where the people of Quraysh had arrived, he stood in front of the camp of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and from far away the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam can see them standing. And Allah Azza wa Jal makes their numbers little in the eyes of the Sahaba so they do not lose motivation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the numbers of the Sahaba small in the eyes of the disbelievers so they could have more motivation to fight them. And then the people of Quraysh will come forward and ask the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to send out three of his main strong men. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam sends out three people from the Ansar, from the Medina. So Utbah, Shayba and Walid look at them and say, who are you? We want people from the people of Mecca who migrated to you. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he calls upon and he says, oh Hamza, oh Ali, oh Ubaidah, get up for the paradise. Get up and fight these people. So they get up. Hamza, Ali, and Ubaidah. Three of them from the family of the Prophet ﷺ, to fight against three strong, powerful warriors from the people of Quraysh. Hamza kills his opponent. Ali kills his opponent. And three of them killed the disbelievers. And now, 330 to fight against 1,000. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is watching. He raises his hands. Oh Allah, oh Allah, the victory that you had promised me. Oh Allah, the victory that you had promised me. Oh Allah, if you destroy these believers, if you destroy these believers today, you will be not worshipped on the surface of this earth ever again. They are the only believers who exist on the surface of this earth. Oh Allah, the victory they had promised me. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes out of his tent, looks in the heavens, and he says, Allahu Akbar, Jibreel with 3,000 angels descending down to support the believers. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfills his promise, where Allah azza wa jal will give victory to those minority, 313, against the majority, 1,000 of disbelievers. 70 from amongst the disbelievers were killed, and 70 were captives, and only 14 from amongst the Muslims were killed. The victory of Allah.